This week seems to be all about the long-anticipated release of Sora. Unfortunately, even if you're in the US, you may encounter problems opening an account with Sora, let alone the whole EU, UK and many other countries currently denied access. But it shouldn't stop you from creating great AI-generated movies. You still have fantastic tools like Runway ML, Luma, Kling and Hailuoai, to name a few, that allow you to tell your stories in a visually compelling way. So, let's remind you of the very recent upgrades to one of these generators. It's Kling's new exciting features we want to review today. Virtual Try-On, Custom Model, Motion Brush, Camera Control, Last Frame, all of these were introduced or updated over the last 3 weeks. Let's review them and see if they are worth the hype. Before we start, we need to point out that the updates to Kling's 1.5 video generator model have noticeably improved output quality in both professional and standard modes. The difference is easy to spot. Now back to the new features. Virtual Try-On, what is it and how it works? Let's start with the Virtual Try-On feature. It allows you to dress your model in any kind of attire you want and generate either a static image or a video of this model in the clothes you've chosen. We tested it to assess if this feature will work for e-commerce business, fashion enthusiasts and AI filmmakers looking to maintain full body character consistency. The process is incredibly straightforward. Upload an image of a garment, choosing a top, a bottom, or a full suit. You can take the existing product image from the web, take the photo yourself, or create your garment with the help of AI. Then you pair the clothing with a model image. You can either upload your own model photo or use Kling's library. If you want your model to be in a specific environment like a street or a moon, you can generate the background using Kling or another text-to-image generator. A pro tip here, custom models you generate with Kling tend to perform better in the try-on function. We observed hands morphing and palms distortions when using models generated in Midjourney or Flux. To bring your dressed model to life, all you need to do is click the Bring to Life button. From now on, proceed like you would with any image to video generation. So, is this feature good enough for e-commerce? It's a solid option for showcasing how clothes might look on someone, but there are some limitations. For example, the AI might not perfectly replicate every detail of the garment, especially with more complex designs. A few extra generations of the image can help here, as Kling might, for example, miss a few buttons or slightly altered pocket designs. You'll need to decide if close enough is good enough for your audience. Will it work for creating a lookbook? Absolutely. If you're a fashion influencer or a costume designer, this is a great tool you can use to bring your ideas to life on various models and in various locations. Even more, how about getting some help picking out your own outfit and getting a feel for how these jeans you're fixing to buy will look on you? Upload a photo of yourself or clone yourself using Kling's custom model feature, add your dream pants and see how you'd look in different outfits before you buy. It's like a virtual dressing room and honestly, we are really in love with it. Will it work for AI filmmakers? Yes, to some extent. You can use try-on function to dress your film character with the outfit you have in mind. Then you can use this image as a reference image to create frames with your character dressed as you want it. Certainly, the final outfit may slightly differ from your initial idea, but it should be close enough and maintain consistency across all shots. We believe it could also be a great tool for costume designers working on traditional films, as they can discuss the character's attire with the film director and cinematographer and check how it will look in particular locations without the need to actually hire a tailor. Let's move on to Kling's custom model feature, which ensures consistent and realistic characters across multiple videos. It works by training a custom model using video clips of your character's face. Once trained, you can use this custom model in your text-to-video projects, keeping your character's face and expressions consistent throughout. Let me use the custom model to tell you a bit about my life. I started drawing storyboards back in the day. Later, I explored the unknown territories, chasing my dreams. Eventually, I found a place where I could organize epic parties. But when I lost my new empire, it kinda got me slightly depressed. Motion brush and camera controls. Another helpful addition to 1.5 model is Kling's motion brush. This tool is already known from the 1.0 model. It allows you to animate up to 6 elements in your shot. You can indicate the movement direction and shape using visual arrows, and even specify where each movement should stop. Now combine it with the updated camera control feature, allowing you to tilt, pan, zoom, and move the camera with sliders, making it easier to plan dynamic and visually compelling shots. Last frame. And here is something we know you love. Kling 1.5 in the professional mode now lets you define both the first and the last frame of your video. This gives you more control over transitions, morphing effects, and overall animation flow. It's a small but powerful update that adds a ton of predictability to your projects. Wrap up. With all these new features, leveled up quality, virtual try-on, custom model, motion brush, camera controls, last frame, it's clear Kling is pushing the boundaries of what AI tools can do. There is still room for improvement, but they are definitely on the right track. Eventually, these features will help a lot in creating AI-generated feature movies with consistent characters, both when it comes to their faces and the way they are dressed. All in all, Kling has remained a strong contender on the market for the ultimate AI video generator. But the rest of the developers are not in a coma, so we expect the coming weeks to reveal more exciting news from the market. For all of us AI filmmakers, any new feature is great news and worth a try. If you enjoyed this breakdown, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more updates, reviews, and tutorials. See you in the next video.